It was a hectic life. I had no life. I was very busy. And though I loved my patients and loved the surgery itself, I decided to try and look at something else in medicine that would be more appropriate for me. I was giving myself away and not taking the time to replenish my own energy. And I burned out. That's the bottom line. When I walked the labyrinth, it was a metaphor for coming home. It has a beginning, a center, and an ending. When I come to the labyrinth, I am in a very thankful mood. With my Native American roots, I'm part Cherokee, I sprinkle tobacco to honor the earth that this labyrinth stands on. Also a Native American ritual, it's the lighting of sage, which is an herb. The fragrance of the sage goes up to the heavens. It's like you're giving your prayers. It's a prayer of preparation. And it's just a personal way how I prepare. It's not done for everybody. I will bring a pad and paper here and start walking the labyrinth. I move when I write. I like to move. I like to be moving. And so I will jot down notes, and great things come to me. Bringing one of my patients' problems in with me. What's the best mode of treatment? How can I help? And so I will think about that problem as I come in. Sometimes I bring my tape recorder with me. And remembering the purpose of why I'm taking this course in the first place, which is another way to help people to heal. And as I reach toward the center, it is a metaphor for the continued path in healing that is my life as a physician and as a person. To stand in each place and just really ponder and maybe come to some solution, and then the closure of that solution of walking back out the same path and saying, yes, this is the way I want to go with this problem, this prayer, this petition, and complete the walk. What I hope to take is peace. Whatever I'm thinking about, to come to peace, to come to a resolve by the end of my walk. And I've never been disappointed, never. The labyrinth to me means home. It has been an enrichment. It's a pattern of peace.